Good morning, all the students. Welcome to the BSc first year. Here, for the BSc first year, there are two papers, paper 1 and paper 2. I will teach you to paper 1, which is mechanics and relativity. So, in this paper, there are 4 units. In first unit, we have seen about the laws of motion. So, there are the 4 units. And in first chapter, we see about the law of motion. So, according to the Newton's, there are 3 laws of motion. According to the Newton's, there are 3 laws of motion. Newton's first law of motion, Newton's second law of motion, Newton's third law of motion. The famous Newton's first law of motion is also called as the law of inertia. The Newton's first law of motion is also called as the law of inertia because it is tell about the inertia inside the body, and inertia is the measure of mass also. So inertia is also called as a measure of mass. So according to the Newton's first law of motion, law of inertia. So according to this law, if the body is at state of rest or of uniform moving with uniform velocity, if it is at state of rest or moving with the uniform velocity, then it continues its state of rest or of uniform velocity unless and until an unbalanced force is acted upon it. So this is the statement of Newton's first law. So according to that, if you consider one of the particle, then it is at rest and or it is moving with some velocity v, then it continues its state of rest or moving with the velocity v unless and until an unbalanced force is acted upon it. Means jo prantya apan tyachyavar kutlahi dusra force apan tyachyavar act karat nahi to prantya ti body tyach state la asel mhanje rest la asel kiwa uniform velocity ne move karat asel. Haa aahe Newton cha pahila niyam. So this is also called as the law of inertia. This law is also known as the law of inertia because it is used to measure the mass of the particle. If there is a bigger mass, then it having the bigger force to move it, and it have a smaller mass, then it should be have to the lower force for that. So this law is known as the law of inertia. Then there is a second law, that is the law of momentum. So Newton's second law is law of momentum.
Chadar sir,
law of momentum. So according to Newton's second law called as the law of momentum, according to this law, the rate of change of linear momentum with respect to time is directly proportional to the applied force. Means rate of change of linear momentum is dp by dt is directly proportional to the applied force. So force is directly proportional to the dp by dt. So this is also written as force is directly proportional to the dp by dt, where p is the momentum. P is the momentum. So P is equal to, it is the product of mass and velocity. So if you solve this equation, that is F is directly proportional to dP by dt, then force is directly proportional to dP by dt. It means that force is equal to some constant times dP by dt. Force is equal to some constant times dP by dt, but here is constant is taken as 1, K is taken as 1, so that F is equal to dP by dt. Therefore, F is equal to dT of mass into velocity. Here, mass is the constant one which is taken outside of the derivative or outside of this. So, F is equal equal to m into d dt of v. So f is equal to m into dv by dt means rate of change of velocity with respect to time is known as the acceleration. So f is equal to m into n. So force is equal to mass into acceleration. Means that whenever there is a change in the momentum, there will be the force. So this is the second law. Newton's third law of motion. This Newton's third law of motion is also known as the law of action and reaction. So, according to this law, for every action, there is equal and opposite reaction. For every action, there is equal and opposite reaction. So, the statement of this law is, for every action, there is equal and opposite reaction. For every action, there is equal and opposite reaction. Means whenever there is action, there will be the equal and opposite reaction. For example, if you are walking, then in the process of the walking, you can apply the backward force on the earth. That's why the earth is moving you in the forward direction so that you can walk. So this is Newton's third law of motion. So according to that, for every action, there is equal and opposite reaction. So these are the three laws. Newton's first law, that is about the inertia. Newton's second law, that is about the momentum. And Newton's third law for the action and reaction. So the example of the Newton's first law is that when you are moving in a bus, so when the driver of the bus is breaks down, then at that time you move in the forward direction. So you are moving with the uniform velocity. When the brake is down, then your body going forward direction because you are in the position of the motion, so that you can continue your position of the motion of the body. So this is the example of the Newton's first law. Now the next point is the frame of reference. Frame of reference. So before knowing about the frame of reference, we first see about the motion. What is meant by the motion? Motion means when the body is moving from one position to the another position. So this motion, this is part of the motion of the particle, but this motion can be seen only when there is some reference about that. Means my hand is moving with the reference to this blackboard or this wall, then you can see that the body is moving. Means we need some references. For example, if you are moving with a train, the two trains going side by side with the same velocity, then you cannot really recognize that which train is moving or both the trains are moving. So for recognition of the motion, we must require some frame. So the motion is going from one particle or one position to the another position with respect to some references behind that. So this is about the motion, and this motion or the position of the particle can be determined by the well-known Cartesian coordinate system. So if you know If you going to know about the position of the particle, then in that time we are required some frame of reference. Frame of reference or the Cartesian coordinate system. Suppose here the particle P inside here, so you have to know about that position of the particle by its coordinate, that is x, y, and z. X, y, and z. P is the particle having the coordinates x, y, and z. So, to know the position of the particle, we have to must require some Cartesian coordinate system. Such Cartesian coordinate system or any other the frame of reference system is known as the frame of reference. So, the coordinate system required to denote a position of particle in space. Particle in space. It is known as frame of reference. So the distance star are considered as the frame of reference. The distance star are considered as a frame of reference. So instead of these three coordinates, there should be the fourth coordinate, that is also known as the time coordinate. So to cover the event, we require the next coordinate, that is the time coordinate. So this time coordinate with the Cartesian coordinate and one time coordinate gives the time frame of reference. So we get space time frame of reference. Space time frame of reference. In this frame of reference, there will be the some Cartesian coordinates and one time coordinate is there. So to cover the any event occur in the universe or in the nature, so that event can be covered with the space and time. So this is about the event occur in the nature. So this is about the frame of references. Means it is a Cartesian coordinate system to denote the position of the particle is known as the frame of references. There are two types of the frame of references. One is inertial frame of reference, another one is the non-inertial frame of reference. So the frame of reference are two types. One is inertial frame of reference, another one is the non-inertial frame of reference. One is the inertial frame of reference. And non-inertial frame of reference. In inertial frame of reference, the inertial frame of reference, this is the frame of reference in which Newton's laws are hold good. Means the Newton's law can be hold good in this frame of reference called as the inertial frame of reference. This is unaccelerated frame of reference. Unaccelerated frame of reference means Newton's three laws, Newton's first law, Newton's second law, and Newton's third law can be applicable here, that is in the inertial frame of reference. But in non-inertial frame of reference, the Newton's laws cannot be hold good. So this is called as the non-inertial frame of reference. It is also called as the accelerated frame of reference. So this one is the accelerated frame of reference. So this one is the accelerated frame of reference. These frames are generally are in the rest or moving with the uniform velocity. So the frames which are at the rest are moving with uniform velocity is known as the inertial frame of reference. That is, the distressed star can be considered as inertial frame of reference, and all the bodies which moving with the uniform velocity with that distressed star is also known as the inertial frame of reference. And in non-inertial frame of reference, these frame of references are moving with some acceleration. So these frame of references are known as the non-inertial frame of references. So it is the accelerated and rotational frame of references are also known as rotational frame of reference is also known as the non-inertial frame of reference. So in rotational means the earth is rotating about its axis, so that earth is rotating about its axis so that it has some acceleration. So the frame attached with the earth is a non-inertial frame of reference, and the frame which is rest or moving with the uniform velocity means same velocity, then it is a inertial frame of reference. So example of the inertial frame is the distant star and the bodies which are moving with the uniform velocities. And the example of this one is the earth moving about its axis is the example of non-inertial frame of reference. So this is about the Newton's three laws and inertial frame of references, inertial frame and non-inertial.